It's Halloween time, so I thought what I'd do is show you four scary problems you can have with your Mac and how you can fix them. So let's go ahead and get started. The first one we're going to look at is forgetting your password, which definitely sucks, especially if you forget your password hint as well. Luckily, this one is fairly easy to fix. Go ahead and insert your install disk and then restart your computer. As your Mac is starting, hold down the C key, and what this is going to do is have the Mac boot off of the disk instead of off of the hard drive. Now, it'll take it a little bit longer to boot up, but once it does, it'll give you the option to choose your language and then an option to go ahead and install OS X. You don't want to do that. What you want to do is on the top, click Utilities, and then you'll see there's a Reset Password option. Go ahead and click that and then follow the steps, and this allows you to reset the password so you can log back into the machine normally. Steve Jobs' hatred of buttons has left us without a manual eject on most Macs since the beginning. Luckily, there's a way you can force a disk to eject if for some reason it's being stubborn and doesn't want to come out. So go ahead and start your computer, and as it's booting, click and hold down on the mouse. Now what this is going to do is essentially tell the Mac to force eject whatever disk is inside. This next one is fairly common, and that is either by accident or on purpose deleting a file, then emptying your trash, and then realizing you need that file later on. Well, there's actually a couple methods you can use to retrieve it, but probably the easiest is if you are a Time Machine user to just go back and use Time Machine. And this is really one of the benefits of using Time Machine vice just doing wholesale backups at random, and that it makes a timeline, hence the name Time Machine, that you can literally go back to and find files. So you can see we can go back here a step, and here's that super important file that I accidentally deleted. You can actually just hit the spacebar and use preview to look at files within Time Machine and make sure that's the one you want. Also, at this point, you can right-click on it and it's going to give you some options either to restore it or even permanently delete it off of Time Machine if it's something that you don't want people to easily go back to. Now, besides using Time Machine, there's also some third-party applications out there that if you're not a Time Machine user, you can use them to go back and retrieve deleted files. Finally, one of the scariest things that can happen to you is that your computer just won't turn on. It just doesn't respond to the power button. Now, after you've gone ahead and checked the power cables and made sure that's not it, kind of your last ditch effort is resetting the SMC, or the System Management Controller. Now what the SMC does is control a lot of the low-level functions of the Mac, kind of the things that run in the background to make it work, including responding to the power button. So to reset it, what you do is you unplug the Mac, hold down the power button for 5 seconds, release the power button, and then re-plug in the power supply. And this is reset your SMC. If you don't have a desktop Mac, instead you have a MacBook, you can go ahead and go to Apple's website, and it tells you how to reset the SMC there. This can also help with some other minor problems too, such as the keyboard backlight not working or the ambient light sensor and various other things. Well, there you go guys, 4 scary problems that you can fix yourself. Hopefully this was useful to some of you guys out there, and I'll see you guys soon in my next video. Later.